I've got my winter curator box. So if you want to see what's inside this luxury box, stay tuned. Hi, and welcome to our channel. My name is Tracey. Chloe and Bandit aren't with me this evening, but if you're new, thanks so much for stopping by. And if you're returning, thank you so much for being a part of our YouTube family. So this is a seasonal luxury subscription box. The price has gone up pretty significantly. I did lock in the previous price, which was $350 for the year. That's for four boxes. But then on top of that, they gave me $50 back in store credits. So it was technically $300 for the year, which I thought was a reasonable price. I will, and they let me extend that out through next year. So I had gotten that last year right after I had already renewed. They offered me to extend it for another year at legacy pricing. The price is going up rather significantly, so I probably will not renew after that, just because the box is lovely, everything in here is lovely, but the price point is a little high for me. Now, this was previously the Rachel Zoe House a Box of Style. So Rachel Zoe does put it out. There are two choice items and the rest she chooses for you. So everybody gets. You can opt to pay extra. So if you say, well, gee, I have this choice of two things, I really want both, you can opt to pay extra. It is a little pricey. It's pricier than, you know, like with FabFitFun, at the most you're paying $18. It's pricier than that. I think it's close to $50, something like that. It's not cheap. All right, so there is your sneak peek. We're going to get right into it with the jewelry piece. So you had a choice between the earrings or the necklace. These are by Liada, and the necklace, let me just put my glasses on so I can read to you. So my Vera Bradley glasses. So the Bryn Pearl Lariat Necklace retails for $85, and the Effie Pearl Drop Huggies retail for $80. So I typically feel like the Huggies pinch my ear. I don't typically wear them. I did opt for the necklace instead, not because it had a higher price point, but because I felt more apt to wear this than earrings that might be a little pinchy. All right, so it's a nice thick chain. I mean, it is kind of a statement piece. All right, so there's how that looks. I think that would look nice with like an open, you know, neck versus this high neck, but very lovely, very nice. A little more dressy than a day-to-day though piece. Next, this was something everybody got, so it wasn't a choice item. It is a set of three from Flannery. We have the Wild Jasmine Hyaluronic Eye Serum. This is for dark circles, it says. This is a cruelty-free brand. Their Everlasting Spring Hibiscus Invigorating Mask. And this is a this can be an overnight mask. You don't have to wash it off. And then last is the Jasmine Sunset Rose Quartz Restorative Face and Night Cream. So that set of three retails for $180 for those three little products. Next by Show Me Your Mumu is a robe. You had a choice between this pink and white striped or an animal print, like a, I don't know if it's a cheetah print right there. Let's do that. Yeah. And that was like a tan and white. This retails for $128. Like I say, this is a more upscale. So this is a very soft satin. I'm sure it's not silk. 100% polyester, so not silk. It is a machine wash, though, line dry. I do think that it's adorable. Is it a winter item? Absolutely not. I get, maybe if you live in California, I guess it is. But if you live in the Northeast or many other places, it is not. So this will be set aside for the summer months, but it is nice to have something light to go out in the summertime while I'm walking the dog in shorts and a little t-shirt, you know, to kind of just have something that's a little bit of a cover up in case my shorts are a little shorter than I would normally wear out. Next, we have a Rachel Miriam pouch. All right, so it's meant to go like this, I guess, but it doesn't close down like that, which is, I mean, there's no like snap or anything to close it down. But when you look at the picture, that's how they have it. And when you look here, that is how she has it styled. And this is a $148 value. $148. Last, we have a throw blanket. This is the Rachel Miriam Cloud Throw Blanket. Make a little tag. This is similar to like a Barefoot Dreams kind of throw blanket. So it's very, very soft, but also not safe for around pets. And I say that, so the pets are not unsafe. The blanket itself is unsafe near pets because the littlest scratching you're gonna have like pull on it. And this is a $128 blanket. Now it's not huge by any means. I mean, it's a good length, but width-wise, it really is just a throw to have around you. All right, very comfy, very cozy, and I mean, I do like it. I do love it. So I just have to be careful with the pets around it. Okay, so that's my Rachel Zoe box. It's a beautiful box. Everything in here is beautiful. It's very well chosen. You get to feel kind of like a celebrity when you get these items. Like, I always feel like I'm a celebrity getting a swag bag when I get this because it's so full of some beautiful, wonderful items. That being said, with the price increase, which is now averages out to a little bit over $100 a box, when it comes up for renewal, unless they offer me again to keep it at the current price, I probably will not. There's sometimes different deals out there though that you can catch. When I first caught this, I basically got the first box for really, really cheap. It ended up being like the price per box was $89. It, with the discount that I had gotten for the first one, it ended up being somewhere along the lines of $50 a box or something like that. So it worked out very nicely. I think the first box was free or $25 or some really, really great price. But now it's over $100 a box. So I will be sad if it has to go, but budget-wise, I can't do over $100 a box for luxury items, you know. All right, well, that's all I have for tonight. Let me know your thoughts. What was your favorite item from the box? Are you suffering from sticker shock? I always am when I open this box. Like, what? People pay that kind of money for this? Like, people pay $128 for a little throw blanket. It's nice. It's cozy. I love it. It's soft as can be. But would I walk into a store and pay $128? No. No, I would not. I wouldn't pay $85 for this. I would get this at Kohl's for like $30. I would not pay that much for that. Like, I just wouldn't pay those prices for those items, but I am happy to get them in a subscription box, all for about the cost of this one necklace. All right, well, that's all I have for now. Please consider hitting that like, subscribe, and notification bell, and hopefully I'll see you soon.